left over. So the next best solution is to times 2 by 3, which equals 6. Now 6 is your common denominator. Next 3 goes into 6 2 times. Write 2 times the numerator 1 equals 2 as your bottom denominator. Now 2 as a denominator goes into 6 3 times. Write a 3 times the top numerator 1, which equals 3. Now you have the top numerator 3 plus the bottom numerator 2 equals 5. Your denominator of 6 stays the same. Now add the whole numbers 5 and 3, which equals 8. Your final answer is 8 and 5 sixths. The total number of hours the student studied was 8 and 5 sixths. Let's do a word problem. There is a contractor cutting lumber. The lumber is 8 and 5 sixths. He cuts 3 and 1 third off. How much lumber is left? The contractor has a piece of lumber that is 8 and 5 sixths. He decides to cut 3 and 1 third off. The first step to figure out how much will be left is to find the common denominator. The two denominators consist of 3 and 6. The smallest denominator is 3, the largest is 6. The number 3 can indeed go into the larger denominator without anything left over, so 6 is the common denominator. The bottom denominator of 3 goes into the common denominator of 6 2 times. Now 2 times the bottom numerator 1 is 2. Next 6 goes into the other denominator of 6 1 time. 1 time the top numerator of 5 is 5. Now 2 is the numerator for the bottom fraction. This is a subtraction problem, so subtract the top numerator 5 from the bottom numerator 2, and your answer is 3 as your new numerator and your denominator stays the same. Your fraction portion is now 3 sixths, which can be reduced to 1 half. Now subtract your whole numbers. 8 subtracts 3 leaves 5. Your answer is now 5 and a half. If the contractor cuts 8 and 5 sixths of lumber 3 and 1 third, it would leave a remaining piece of 5 and a half. If a contractor has a 2 by 4 that is 8 and 1 third long and cuts 3 and 5 sixths of it, how much of the 2 by 4 will be left? The first thing is to stack the 8 and 1 third over the 3 and 5 sixths. The next thing is to find the common denominator. You have the top denominator of 3 and the bottom of 6. The small denominator of 3 can go into the larger denominator with nothing left over. This means that the larger 6 denominator is the common denominator. The bottom denominator of 6 goes into 6 1 time. 5 times 1 equals 5. Now let's do the top denominator. 3 goes into 6 2 times. So 1 times the 2 equals 2 as the top numerator. Now you have to subtract the top numerator from the bottom numerator. At this time you can't, because the top numerator is smaller than the bottom numerator. So you must borrow from the whole number 8. We have to keep in mind when you borrow from the whole number that the numerator 6 becomes 6 over 6, which equals to 1 that you borrowed. Now add the top numerator 2 to the new numerator of 6, which equals 8. Subtract the top numerator of 8 from the bottom numerator of 5, which equals to 3. 3 is now your numerator and your denominator of 6 stays the same. Now you have 3 sixths, which can be reduced to 1 half. Now subtract the whole numbers 7 and 3. 7 take away 3 is 4. Your final answer is 4 and a half. The contractor will have 4 and a half remaining. This is Reggie the contractor. He is building a house and must cut a piece of wood that is 10 and 5 eighths. He would like to cut it down to 4 and a quarter. First thing is to stack up 10 and 5 eighths and 4 and a quarter. This is a subtraction problem, so we must put the subtraction sign. Next, find the common denominator. The small denominator can go into the larger denominator evenly with nothing left over. So the larger denominator will be our common denominator. The bottom denominator 4 goes into the common denominator 8 2 times. So the numerator 1 times 2 is 2.